kiss. I love you that ain't left my lips. Drains me on my fingertips. But I'm reaching, hey, I'm reaching. You may be tired, but I ain't leaving on my own. You may be tired, but I ain't leaving away. I did this record a little while. I went crazy a few years back and had a rough go of it. And the long and short of it is, as part of my therapy, I started working on a record called Killing Uncle Buzzy, which I happen to have a bunch of copies over here. And what formerly used as a six-pack cooler is now my CD carry-arounder. And that record kind of changed my life and helped me in a lot of ways, and one way that it helped is that it started growing legs and winding up on famous people's buses, and it wound up on Jake Owens' bus, and he loved it, and he cut it, and it was his last single, and he was very kind, he put me in a couple of his videos. We all know what we got.
She's moving on.
talking to a good friend of mine, Levi Lowry, and we started talking about members of our family and how crazy some of them were. And I told him, I said, I'd love to write a song, and it would sound kind of like if the Coen brothers wrote country music. Yeah, and so that's the way that we set out between our two families. We did not have to tell one damn lie in this song. It's all true, although I will not say whose family's who. But any of y'all got any crazy people in your families? Just out of curiosity. Well, we down south, we put our crazy on display. We don't hide it. We just brag on it and let our freak flag fly.
I'm not proud.
So, with that said, this is me kind of giving kudos to Flannery O'Connor.
I've been going on and on and on and on.
stuff. I do have a website, TravisMeadows.com. You can find everything you want on there and probably a lot of shit you don't care about. You can buy CD there. You can find out where we're going to be next. That's where I have to go to find out where I'm going next because I can't even keep up with my car keys. Well, I do appreciate y'all being so kind, and I was looking around. I couldn't find an ugly one in the bunch. This is a really good-looking crowd. I don't know what they're putting the water up here, though. Good stuff, good stuff. This is the title track on Dierks Bentley's latest release. I wrote this with a good friend of mine, a very optimistic young fella. I did not put it on my last record, but I was making reference a little earlier to going through kind of a hard time, and I felt like I was feeling better about life, and I wanted to write a song to document, which is pretty much what all my songs do. I can't afford a therapist, so I write songs, and it's, so far it's working out pretty good. But this song is, this is on Dierks Bentley's new record, and it's supposed to be the new single. I haven't heard it on the radio yet, but I can be quite an obsessive little bastard, so I try not to pay too much attention to it. I drive myself crazy. I never leave home paying attention to it. If you do have country radio stations up here, please call them and ask for this song requested on the radio, because the reality is, I did not get into music for the money. And I still don't make any. I could have been a doctor. I could have been a lawyer, but I turned out that a long time ago I figured out that I could make things right. And so that's my career choice right there. Thank you so much. I love each and every one of you in a very deep and personal way. Just like a cousin, which means we could be married. Okay, I'll play it. Get out.